Hey guys,
and welcome to another video. This video will be episode 18 of my Resident Rise Let's Play. So, like always, I will quickly show you what I did between the episode. It isn't too much this time, and I'll show you what I got planned this episode. So, what I got planned is, well, like I did last episode, pretty much work off this list of my, well, to-do list, which is making some buildcraft lasers, start working on some fluid cells for applied energistics, and start working on a mine factory reloader farm. Also, I added one more thing, which is basically something to do with the test with smelteries, but I'll show you, well, probably in one or two episodes, what my ideas were about that. So, yeah, like I said, buildcraft lasers. So, buildcraft lasers are a pretty cool aspect from buildcraft, which basically allow you to create these kinds of chipsets. And I believe also some other stuff. And these are used in quite a lot of buildcraft related recipes, but mainly these gates, which are quite nice and have lots and lots of functionality. So I'll show you what it does later. So how many should I make? Let's quickly see how much space I have. If we get down here, I disabled my reactor for now. It was draining a lot of energy, so. And when I'm not using these machines anyway, this will suffice. Yeah, I'm thinking just maybe. I don't want to do this. Quickly get my hammer out and turn my sound down a bit. Let's see. Where's my hammer? Where is it? Didn't delete it, did I?
I'll be right back, guys.
Well, I guess I accidentally deleted that one. Wow, that wasn't smart. So yeah, I'll have to create one or recreate one sooner or later, but yeah, I'll do that someday off camera. I think just between some of the guts in this episode, because a hammer is one of the nicest things to have and I wouldn't want to miss it. So let's see, maybe I can make something else just for now that can mine stuff very fast, just while I'm at it. One of the things that mines very fast is the atomic disassembler, I think it is. Yeah, this thing. It is rather expensive, but it's absolutely worth it. So, let's see. Do I have any of the materials that this thing requires? Just for now. So I can... might as well create it when I'm at it. So let's see. No, I do not. Then I'll get the resources and I'll be right back. Okay, there we go. One atomic core. And then let's see. Put this back. And get myself an energy tablet. And now... one atomic disassembler, nice, which is put at block efficiency 2, 8, 24, 64, and 100. Nice. 100 is basically the max speed. So I also used this thing in my previous Let's Play, and this thing is awesome, and I'll show you why in just a sec. Okay, so let's see. Yeah. Instant mine, everything at 100. I wanted to create this thing for quite a while, but never really got around to it. Might as well do it now. So, my idea was to put the lasers right here at this wall. Would look pretty nice, I think. And not too bad in any way, so... let's quickly make this one more spot deeper. Wow, this tool is absolutely perfect. It almost makes you think that maybe a bit... overpowered in just a little bit. So let's see. Cover this up. Yeah, I'll clean this up later. So maybe I can put like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 right there, and then the assembly table right there. I think that would be not a too bad idea. So let's see. I got myself 3. So if I get myself laser, then this one, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Nice. Then I need to get myself an assembly table. This one. Which requires some gears. And while I'm at it, I might as well add these things to this stuff, because I will probably need it anyway. So, let's see. Get myself some sticks, because this is one of the only recipes that I don't have much, or that doesn't work too well with the entire, yeah, this thing. So let's see, wood gear, then stone gear, force gear, no, gold gear. Like that. Gold gear. And then I need iron gear. And then I can put myself into the gold gear. Diamond gear. Like that. That's the one I want. So let's see. I can just put it right there. Don't have anything dedicated to... yeah. This stuff yet. So do it like that. This can go there. Nice. And then get myself one diamond gear. And this should be working. Yeah, crafting stuff. Nice. This is pretty cool. Wait, I forgot to show you guys what I did between the episodes. Oh well, I'll quickly cover it right now. Well, first of all, I added some stuff to this molecular assembly table. Only these 3 pages, I think. Yeah. Just some stuff that might come in, or might be just a bit useful later on, so nothing too interesting otherwise. What else? I added this sand generator, pretty simple, but useful. So let's see, place. This can be annoying if I want it to be symmetrical in any shape or way. You know what? I'll quickly do it like this. Just because I can. It's not like that I'm low on resources or anything anyway, so why not? Okay, then. Let's see. I need some energy cables. Or, yeah, these redstone conduits. And I can place them like right there. And then I can just cover them up later, so it won't be an issue. Then run them down there. Awesome. So I can quickly do it like this. Then place this down. Break this conduit. Nice. Quickly cover it up again. Because this should be all I really need. Get myself some covers really quickly. Stone covers are always useful. And then I need to get myself 2 more of those lasers. Yeah. Laser. That doesn't work, I see. Laser, 2 more. Letting my digital miner run overnight really lets me improve my resources. Okay, so I should be able to do it, hook it up like this. And I don't have to change anything on it, I guess. Oh. Awesome. Then my assembly table can go right there. And this thing eats power, so let's quickly turn this thing back on. And yeah, it's producing power again. So let's see. Quickly look something up that can be put into this assembly table. So for example, redstone chipsets, gold, iron. Yeah, let's see, what can this stuff be used for? Oh yeah, ME advanced processors. And this thing, yeah. Let's quickly show you guys how to make lots of these golden processors thingies. Which will be cheaper using it this way instead of the other way, because, well, this thing is just a bit more efficient. So, let's see. redstone, make himself a stack of that stuff, gold, stack of that stuff, and plunk it in there. Again, create that. These things are heating up, or sort of. And blue is the max speed. And, oh yeah, it's cooking along. Nice. So, is it, yeah, more than enough power. Nice. So yeah, that's pretty much how this thing works. Then, also on a side note, if you place a chest next to it, like I think any chest would suffice, but I'll just place a vanilla chest next to it, this will automatically dump whatever it creates into this chest. So yeah, I got that going for now. Cool. It does take some time, but you know, whatever. So then I can put this stuff back. And that's one more thingy done. Buildcraft lasers, nice. So, then I want to get into the fluid cells from Applied Energistics. To be honest, I've never messed with those things a lot, or like not even at all, but I've heard from people like Kieran Dave that uses these things that it works pretty cool actually, so yeah, might as well. So, let's see. For that I will, well, I think first of all I need a new ME drive, so let's see if, is there anything sort of special drive that I need? I don't think I do. Just if it does, then I will just be screwing up on this a bit. Always fun. But yeah, I guess it doesn't. So let me get myself one of those cells, because this one is almost full already. Let me drive. Then I'll place it, well, you know, just right there. Not that it matters too much. Then I need some of these fluid storage cells. I think that's all I really need, to be honest. So let's see. For these I need Surtur quartz glass, which is crafted like that. Okay, not too bad. And then Surtur tanks. Okay. Oh, I will need a lot of this glass stuff. So, let's see. Do I have much quartz dust? Yeah, I'll just use this instead of the normal quartz, because this stuff is a bit easier to mine. then I need like 3, 4, 5, 6. I'll just make one big drive, like 16k. I'm not sure if that's like a lot in any way, but you know, might as well try. So I need a lot of these, which require, let's see, I need 1, 2, 3, so I need 9 of these. And what was it again? Flux dust. Ha. Hate flux dust. Always low on it. Like really. So 9 of these. Then let's see. I need to get myself these things, and then I can create this, then get this. Awesome. I think, can I put this in there? Yep, I can. I think, can I put it one block to the right? Yeah, it looks to be working. That's nice. What else do I need? It seems like I need... Let me quickly do some messing around with this, because I'm not really sure what else I need beyond this point, and I'll be right back. Okay, after some messing around in single player, I finally understood a bit better how all these things work. So, first of all, I need a fluid terminal, which basically, yeah, allows you to access fluids the same way you can with these craftings and the other kind of terminal. So yeah, that's pretty much what I need to do. And then we do this. And fluid terminal. Nice. I'm already a bit out of space here. Let me quickly just place it there. And it's working. But as you can see, there is currently no fluid in this yet. And what kind of fluids would I be able to store in this? Well, pretty much everything, including liquid experience. This is also one of the things that I would really like to have imported into the system, so I can use it in, well, other ways. So, do I still have some not enough dimensional transceivers? Because then I can also clean that mess up right over there in the, well, the other room that I have. So, transceiver. Let's see, what am I missing? An eye vendor. And one of those octuple thingy. Then two of these. Then one of these. And I only need one more of these. So that's nice. I think I should be able to do is simply break this for now. And this, then hook this up, create a new one, let's just say XP juice, send then public, private, add channel, then fluid mode, send only, and get this thing and this stuff. And wrench it up. Okay, cool. Now what I need to do is run over here. And I should be able to... I think I need... how can I do this? Let's see. Extra cells. I don't think this will work. So, I think what I need to do is get myself one of these fluid import buses. So that should be pretty easy to do. And yeah, let's quickly see that. I need one of these things. Oh wait, these things, sorry. Probably don't have much of that stuff yet. Nah. Then get some of these. Oh, or one of these. Whatever. Then a sticky piston. Piston. And slime ball. That's the one I meant. There's an import bus. There's a precision import bus. There is... No, wait. And there we go. As easy as that. Yeah, that's all I think I need. Then I should be able to... how I got this in mind is I will need one tank, probably. And then where would I be able to hide this? Where is some space? Can I do it like right there? I think this should work. Doesn't have to be too fancy, but... So I can place this deck right there, just like that, then a tank, and this should be outputting, and then a fluid import bus, always active, moving, all of it. And now, I'm not getting liquids. Let me quickly look it up again. I should also add these cables simply in this system, just because I will need them anyway, someday. Oh, yeah, definitely working. And now it's storing bytes of fluid juice. Wait, I didn't meant to place this thing down. That's right. Well, it's empty now anyway, so might as well. I meant to place this thing down. Where it receives liquid. Does it also require power? It doesn't, right? Is it doing anything? If I disable this thing. Why is this not working? Let's see. This seems to be working. Send XP juice. Yes. You know what? I might as well do this. So I can change this up. Just where does it go? There it is. I can just do this. I mean, why not? Then I can break this one. I'll change this up anyway, so get back here. Place this down. Turn this to output mode. Turn this to input mode. And now it's storing all of the XP juice into my system. Nice. So pretty much, I will now be storing all of this juice instead of in tanks, just simply in this system. Awesome. So, is it using much of this stuff? No, not too much. This should suffice more than plenty. So that's cool. Yeah, I can just add this. I think it's done. Pretty much, at least, part of this system is done. Not everything. But what I need to do now is probably get this thing back set up. So it outputs back from the system. So basically this thing is a buffer between the system and the rest. So let's see. Still not using too much. Nah. Wait, how much is storing? That's quite a lot of buckets. Oh wait, no, that's millibuckets, sorry. let's see. What I need to do then is get myself a fluid export bus. Extra cells. Then fluid export. Need more of these. More of these. Let me just quickly add these things in there. You know, might as well. Like one of these. And then I needed one of these cables, one of these. Then I should be able to simply add sticky pistons, which is a piston and a slime ball. Doesn't show up in my NEI for some strange reason. Okay, that's nice. Then get that printed in there. Get this printed in there. Then do the same with this thing. Get this printed in there. And this. Then I will also need some of these covered cables. This will just make it a little bit easier for me to do all this work. Get this printed, then fluid import bus, print, fluid export bus, print. That's a lot of stuff. Let's see, I can simply dump it all into there, I think. Nice. So let's see, if I request myself one fluid export bus, what am I missing? It doesn't seem to be missing anything. Oh, hey. That was easy. I guess I should just be able to do this. Then do get my dimensional transceiver. And XP choose send. Get it also set to send. And then this thing should be... I need to get one bucket. I think. XP juice buckets. Moving max capacity. Then get back here. Place this down. And let's quickly test this. And if not, I'll have to do some more testing. But if not, I don't know why it doesn't work. Apparently this thing just doesn't want to work. Why would that be? Why are you doing this? Oh well, you know, let's quickly check on my time. And, well, we're already at the almost 25 minute mark. So I guess I'll quickly hold up to these two things for the next episode. So I will have something to do to them. And basically, I don't think that these things will take one episode each, so I should be able to do that in either, probably next episode. So, between the episodes, I will quickly figure out that this thing isn't working. It's probably something pretty obvious, but, you know, I'm not that kind of an obvious guy. And I'll clean up the mess, what I did down there, and make everything connected a bit. So yeah, thanks for watching, please leave a rating, and I'll see you guys all next time.